Hey everybody, welcome to my channel, Angel Says Life, where I talk about music, life stuff, mom shit, travel, and spirituality, and all of the above. I like to talk about the many things that I am passionate about, but right now I had to jump on here to talk about Slim Shady, aka Eminem, who is pissing people off. And I knew this was gonna happen. I was just waiting for it to drop, but that's what he does best. You know, he has a history of pissing people off and saying things that are politically incorrect. That it's being claimed that Generation Z is pissed and they want him canceled. Before we switch over, I just want to say thank you. I'm at 421 followers. If you look at the algorithm and what the analytics are telling me, I'll put it right here. I am super close to like starting a membership on my channel, which is another way for me to monetize. It'd be awesome to get a little bit of coin from this channel. I appreciate everybody who is putting in the effort. You know, you may not be able to eventually become a member, but guess what? It doesn't cost you anything to give me a thumbs up, to give me a like, you know, to share this content and to engage with these videos in the comment section. I really do appreciate every single one of you. So thank you. All right, let's go.
Gen Zers called for Eminem to be canceled over his history of controversial lyrics. It's a battle of the generations here, setting social media on fire.
If you unironically listen to this grandpa geezer ass rap, bro, you're fucking cooked.
My transgender cat Siamese identifies as black but acts Chinese. You have to just actually be brain dead to enjoy this kind of music.
I'm gonna say that shit. Cancel me. What? Okay, that's it. Go ahead, Paul. Quit. Snake ass prick. You nail cross-dressing, fake ass bitch, and I'll probably get shit for that. Why? But you can all suck my dick, you fat. Fuck them, fuck Dre, fuck Jimmy, fuck me, fuck you, fuck my own kids, the brats.
Hey, it's Paul. I was listening to the album. Good fucking luck. You're on your own.
It's my last trick. Just like that, and I'm back, bro.
Listen. I'm going to be so straightforward. I may not believe in everything that M said. I may not agree with everything that M said. But I'm going to go over some of the things that I think had been so triggering for some people. I'm just going to go over some of the bars that I think is what is triggering people to call for his cancellation. But I will hit an 8-year-old in the face with a participation trophy. Listen, I'm an old head, I guess. I come from an era where, you know, you're not always going to get a trophy for participating. You get a trophy for winning. You get a trophy for placing first, second, third. You don't always get a trophy for everything that you do. And that's, he's coming from that point of view about life. We've gotten into this societal situation where everyone gets congratulated. All of, like, kids are just learning how to just be congratulated for every freaking thing. No, that doesn't build grit. It doesn't build character. It doesn't have to be abusive, but it also, you shouldn't just be handed everything. And that's what he's talking about. And this is really triggering people. He says, because I have zero doubts that this whole world is about to turn into some Girl Scouts. No shade against Girl Scouts. I was one. And he's not shading Girl Scouts. What he's saying is that, you know, Girl Scouts are do-gooders. They're, you know, looked at as like Puritans almost. You know what I mean? Like, he's saying have a thicker skin. Not everything needs to be an argument or an upset, or it's like people are not going to agree with you. And so the F what? Oh my goodness. No, I know that's what he's saying because I know him. In my youth, everybody who's my age, we were in high school and we got to hear the truth from M about how he felt about the world, and he gave everybody the big F you and was kind of like, this is how I feel. But we don't need to be sitting here just like straight up canceling people for having something to say. Sometimes I wonder what the old me would say if he could see the way shit is today. When I did the reaction to this, I already knew where this was going. I already knew. And then he would say, well, he would say that that shit's gay. You know, growing up in the 90s and 2000s, we used to use that term, oh, that's gay. Like, honestly, we did. To describe something that was not good, or not just necessarily literally someone who was gay. It was like, oh, that's hella gay. Like, I'm from the Bay Area, so we say hella. That's hella gay. Like, that's not cool. It's not cool. So we saw the error of our ways to associate being homosexual with something that's not good, right? It took us maturity and later on to realize, okay, we shouldn't say that anymore. That's fine. It's okay to look back and say, that wasn't cool. We definitely should change that and not say that anymore. I think M is taking a dig at society right now on purpose, and he's doing it in a way where he knows it's going to trigger people. Okay, the next set of bars, I think, is what set people over the edge. My transgender cat, cat's Siamese, identifies as black but acts Chinese. I hop on tracks like a kangaroo and I say a few things or two to anger you. So in other words, he's saying, I'm doing this because it angers you. I'm doing this because you are such a snowflake that the slightest thing that I say, you're going to come for me and you're going to say my whole career needs to be canceled. He's knowingly going into this, releasing this single, knowing that people are going to come for him. Honestly, my personal favorite line in here is, if I think that shit, I'm going to say that shit. I mean, I understand that because I'm that type of person. And then he says, cancel me what? Okay, that's it. Waiting, looking at his watch, going, so it's gonna drop in 3, 2, 1. He already knew. But I think he's at the point in his career where he doesn't give a F. He's tired. These headlines are saying, oh, it's Gen Z. Gen Z is so upset about this. They're calling for his being canceled. I don't like using umbrella statements, right? I don't like saying, oh, it's Gen Z. I know damn well it's not all of Gen Z. I have a Gen Z daughter. She's raised by me and my husband. And honestly, she doesn't hate Eminem. Like, she might not always agree with everything that he says, but honestly, she thinks this shit is funny. Nobody knows how to joke anymore. Nobody knows how to just laugh at themselves or be light. Everything is so damn serious all the time. I am an elder millennial. That's what I call myself. But I can kind of identify a lot with Gen X. I am an elder millennial that doesn't hate it. I thought the song was funny as hell. You know, I grew up in the era of freaking South Park. And when they made fun of everybody. I grew up in the era of In Living Color, sketch comedy that made fun of everybody. I'm all for everybody being who they are, but guess what? That also includes Eminem. I had to come on here and just do a little stint about this because I think that the fact that we all could watch our watches, including Eminem, and say, they're going to be coming for me pretty soon here. And they did. They are. No, the man does not deserve to be canceled. Literally, like, come on. We have so many more things in the world to worry about, like, on a real concerning level. I think this is crazy. All right, guys, that's my two cents on this. You can agree with me or not. Let's talk about it in my comment section. Again, thank you to everybody who's following me. This is it for some very quick music news. All right. Thanks, and I'll see you next time. Peace.